Hello friends, today I am going to show you a new feature that has been introduced as part of C# 10. It is called as global using. So in order to show you this example, I am using Visual Studio 2022. So open Visual Studio 2022 and create a new project like this, and then select this console app, click on next button, and give a name to this project. So demo using is your project name. Click on next and create. So once this project is created, so you can see this program.cs. This is the only file in this project. So first of all, let's discuss what is using. So a using directive allows us to interact with the elements of that are present inside a namespace directly, so without using the full naming convention, which means, let's say there is a namespace called as models. If we are creating a class inside that model called a student, then either you can access that by saying model.student, or you can say using model and then access student directly. So I will show you what I mean. Create a folder called as model. Inside model, let me add a class called as student. So here you can see the namespace name is demo using dot model. Demo using is your project name, and model is this particular folder name, and the class within this is student. So if I want to access this class student from outside this folder, then in that case I have to refer it using the full naming convention. So let's create some field within this. So one is the ID and let's say name. So we have two properties in this, so ID and name. Now I want to access it from program. In that case, what I can do is I can say demo using dot model dot student, and then I can create a student object. And so that is one of the ways of instantiating a student object, and then we can use the properties within the student object. So student dot name, you can see all the properties, name and ID here, and you can then use those properties. So that is one way of doing it. So if we don't want to do that, because every time you are referring to student, if you want to instantiate a type student, then you have to then use the full name. So which is like demo using dot model dot student. So if you want to avoid it, you can do it by saying using demo using dot model, and then you can see I can remove this reference from here and there are no errors, which means everything is fine. So we can do this way also. So if I want to instantiate it again, so it is very easy for me because I can just go and again instantiate it, print to, and you can see that it is very easy to refer. Now, what if you want to use it in, so there are lots of other files also, and you want to use this student type there in those files. For example, let me create another class. Add class plus employee. Now I have employee class. Now I want to access student from here. You can see that I cannot access. It is throwing an error. So I can use using statement here. So in that case, I can just copy this using, and then so you can see that now I can actually access it, student, so tab, and then I can say new student, and then I should be able to access student object. For that I need to first create a constructor, and then if I say student.id or name, I can access these properties, and then let's say I want to initialize it like this, so I can do this. So that is how we use the using. But that is not very convenient, because wherever you want to use this, then you have to add this using directive in all those files. So if we don't want to do this and reduce the amount of code which we are writing, then another way of doing it is declaring it as global. So you can declare it as global in any file. So for example, let me remove it from here. Now you can see that error has come up. But if I go here and say global and save it, so let me go back, and now you can see that the error is not there, and although I have not added the using, I'm still able to use the student type here. So I can also remove it from any, so I can said there is no use of, there is no point in using directives throughout the code, and just declare it at one place and use the global directive there. So one place to declare it is the program.cs, where you whatever global usings you want to use, you can declare all those in program.cs, or you can create another file, let's call it like declaration or something, and then you can also do it there. So let's say add declaration, so where all our global things are initialized. So remove this and then copy, paste, and save everything. So now you can see so there is no using here, there is no using here, so but still the code is fine, there is no error, and we can build it. The build started and build succeeded, so there are no errors. So that is what I wanted to show. So this is how you can make use of the global using directive that is part of C# 10.